In this tutorial, I'll show you how to integrate the popular ImGUI library into your SFML-based project. Now, ImGUI isn't officially compatible with SFML, but there is a popular third-party library that fixes that. Also, if you don't already have SFML set up, then I have a tutorial for that as well. So first things first, let's download the official ImGUI repo and the third-party one as well. You can find links to both of them down in the description. Once that is done, create an ImGUI folder in the main directory of your project and open it up. Now open up the ImGUI repo download and extract all .cpp and .h files into the ImGUI folder except for the demo. Then open up the SFML ImGUI repo and again extract all .cpp and .h files into the ImGUI folder. Now open up your project in Visual Studio, go to Solution Explorer, click on Show All Files, right-click on the ImGUI folder and select Include in Project. Then go to the properties of your project and make sure you have selected all configurations for your configuration. Under C/C++, go to General and in additional include directories, add $solution_directory/imgui/. The final configuration step is to go to Linker, then Input, and under additional dependencies, add OpenGL32.lib. Now go to imconfig.h and include imconfig-sfml.h into it. If you now include imgui.h and imgui-sfml.h into your main C++ file and run the program, you should get no errors. If you do get errors, repeat the previous steps very carefully and see if the problem is fixed. If not, Google your error or leave a comment below. All that's left to do now is to add a few more lines of code that will allow us to use normal ImGUI functions. We'll simply initialize the window, create a delta clock, process the ImGUI events, update ImGUI, render ImGUI, and at the very end, shut it down. Make sure ImGUI is the last thing you render, otherwise your UI might be covered up. And that's everything you need to do in order to use ImGUI with SFML. I'll now go over the very basics of ImGUI, so stick around if you're interested in those. So let's start by making a simple UI window using the begin and end functions and add some text into it using the text function. You should now have a resizable ImGUI window when you run the application. From now on, any other function we'll be looking at will be added inside one of these windows and the order in which they are written dictates the order in which they appear in the UI. Now let's create an if statement with a variable that will decide whether or not to draw the circle and then link the variable to an ImGUI checkbox like so. Now we have control over the existence of the mighty circle. Another very useful function is slider float, which we can link to something like the radius of the circle and give it a lower and upper bound. So now we also have control over the radius of the circle in real time. We can also use slider int to control the amount of triangles the circle is made out of, like so. The final function I'll be presenting is the color edit 3, which we can use to dynamically change the color of the circle while running the program. Now, I'll just slightly modify the code so that the circle is always centered, since otherwise it would bother me. So there we have it, a small SFML application with ImGUI integrated into it. Feel free to join my Discord server for a nice chat, and a big thank you to all my Patreons who support me in the making of my content. As always, all relevant sources and resources are in the description.